Computing products of matrices is tedious. Computing powers of matrices is even worse, because you have to compute a lot of products. In this video, however, you will learn that in some cases the computation of powers of matrices need not to be hard at all. If you can find a so-called diagonalization of a matrix A, computing high powers of A becomes a lot easier. That's nice, of course, for some basic computation exercises, something like compute A to the power 10, but we will need this kind of computations a lot later on when we encounter, for example, discrete dynamical systems. So this is not just some mathematical trick. Let us see what a diagonalization is and how we can compute these powers of matrices in this video. We'll start with two examples, with the matrix D, a diagonal matrix, which means that we have only numbers on the diagonal, zeros otherwise, and some matrix A with a lot of rubbish. What happens if we try to compute powers of a diagonal matrix? Well, let's do D squared first, so use the row column rule. So inner product 1, 0 with 1, 0 equals 1. Inner product 0, 2 with 1, 0 equals 0. Inner product 1, 0 with 0, 2 equals 0. And inner product 0, 2 with 0, 2 equals 4. And you see D squared yields another diagonal matrix. Is that a coincidence? Well, let's try to compute D cubed. Use row column rule again. Inner product 1, 0 with 1, 0 equals 1. Inner product 0, 4 with 1, 0 equals 0. Inner product 1, 0 with 0, 2 equals 0 again. And inner product 0, 4 with 0, 2 equals 8. And you see we still have a diagonal matrix. And you see how you can compute those powers now. If you want to compute D to the power k, you have your 1 to the power k, first spot on the diagonal element, and 2 to the power k, say 2, 4, 8, etc., on the other spot. So computing higher powers of diagonal matrices is a lot easier than computing powers of some general matrix. Because also in general this works. If you want to compute the kth power of a diagonal matrix, you just have to take the kth power of all diagonal elements. But what if you have some matrix A? How can we compute A to the power k? And it doesn't work like that. You cannot take just the kth power of every element. That's not going to work. So in general, you just have to compute A and A times A and A times A times A. That's a lot of products. Fortunately, if A equals PDP inverse, so if A is not diagonal itself, but if A is similar to a diagonal matrix, you can still compute the higher powers of A easily. Well, in this case, we have that A equals PDP inverse. It's this particular P over here. It's this P inverse over there. If you don't believe it, just check, compute P times this D times P inverse, and check whether you get A. And how can we use this to compute, say for example, A cubed? Well, A cubed would be A times A times A. PDP inverse, PDP inverse, PDP inverse. And now you see something nice happens. Those P inverses and P cancel out. Those P and P, P inverse and P cancel out, so we are left with the first P, the D times D times D, so the D cubed, and the P inverse. See, you can generalize this, just put a lot of more A's behind each other, and all the P and P inverses cancel out, and you have a formula for A to the power K. You need P and P inverse, and you only need to compute D to the power K. But computing D to the power K, that is easy. So A to the power k becomes P times D to the power k times P inverse. So instead of k multiplications, and k can be 10 or 100 or 1000 or whatever, you only have to do 3 multiplications. This one over here and this one over here. So what is this property over here that you can write A as P times D times P inverse? Well, that has gotten its own name. A matrix which can be written like that is called diagonalizable. A diagonalization of A is finding a matrix P and a matrix D, an invertible matrix P, such that A equals P times D times P inverse. Or if you use the word similar, A is diagonalizable if A is similar to a diagonal matrix. So how can we find such a matrix P and such a matrix D? Well, it will be the subject of some next videos.